Very cool. 321 FEDS, Freedom Express. The feds are here, buddy. This is Coachmen's highest level trailer and lightweight, the Freedom Express is, and we have equipped it as such. This is a Liberty Edition, which is an upgrade package. Also has a Premier package, frameless windows, a bunch of stuff is optional and present in this video. The reason I specify that is because pricing can change based on equipment, and not every single one of these that we sell this year is gonna be equipped exactly like this. So if at any point you enjoy this video, you wanna see what it's running and how it's equipped, I left you a link down here in the video description. Click for price and availability. It's right there, it's all transparent. We don't hide numbers. Our trailers' prices don't change if you do or don't have a trade. We don't do that kind of business. So, now that that's over, this is awesome. And what's funny, I was talking with a good friend of mine yesterday. He made the comment, he says, you know, Josh, I've noticed what's old is suddenly new again. And it certainly seems to be holding true in RVs. This is not necessarily a new floor plan by any stretch of the imagination. Actually, it's quite a classic floor plan. The old Coachman models used to have front entertainments like this for more park-friendly or seasonal-ish type living. And this is dramatically updated. It's not a carbon copy clone of what used to be produced, not by any stretch, but that the concept and the spirit of that classic camper still exists in this like space age modern ultralight here. And this is a true ultralight. The Freedom Express is one of the most copied ultralights on the market. Other brands have, you know, often replicated but never duplicated what they have going on here. The idea behind this is if you're going to like go someplace for like extended camping, you know, you're gonna go 2 weeks, 2 months and then bop around or something, this is your trailer. Because it's just under 8,090 pounds as we have it equipped here. So keep in mind, that's probably quite a bit for anything but the latest, heaviest half tons. You're still probably gonna wanna be a little more comfortably three quarter here, but if this were conventionally constructed, not an ultralight model, it'd easily be 9,400 pounds. It's significantly lighter than it could be. So that's, there's no definition of ultralight. It's a relativity is what it is. So Liberty Edition gives us this beautiful full front cap, and they've just got it stickered up and decaled real nice, and the flow of it is awesome. You know, power awning, power tongue jack, all the easy push button stuff you can imagine. I believe we've got power stabilizers here. That's an option sometimes we'll put on these. Freedom Express, Coachman does a little bit different. They tongue mount their spare tires. They do that for two reasons. Load equalization for less bouncing down the road. And secondly, it leaves the rear bumper wide open, so you can put a bike rack and stuff on there. Most brands want to tell you, don't do that. You're going to void our structural warranty. And Coachman, with over 50 years of experience building campers, goes, that's a load of garbage. You have to have a place to put bikes and things. Now, a couple little updates at the time of this filming from previous generations. The handy true one-hand operated baggage doors are nice with the magnetic latch system. And this is a full pass-through. Now, this is killer. Because when I saw they're doing a front entertainment, oh, crap, they're going to kill the pass-through storage that they love so much. Nope. There it is. Bam! It's still there, right where it's always been. And that's what's awesome about this, is they've actually increased total cubic foot of outside storage on this model as compared to a standard rear bedroom, or front bedroom rather. They did awesome. Now, you've got additional outside storage over here below the rear master bedroom suite slide out. And you see that white box right there. This comes with a 2-foot by 4-foot indoor-outdoor picnic table you can use. And it's a resin top, so if you leave it outside in the rain, who cares? And also notice the aluminum framework we're looking at here. This is aluminum framed, laminated walls, floor. We have a traditionally constructed roof because what they found is they were not decreasing weight. They were only increasing cost. Fully walkable, totally structural. It's great. Black tank flush, outside shower. Not going to spend a lot of time on this side of the coach. I do like how all your hookups and everything are in one spot, though. That is smart. You do have a second drain over here. That's because this thing has an additional gray tank because the kitchen's over here and the bath is over here. They're far enough apart they put a second tank on. Wide stance stability axles. Why do they have these on here? Again, for obviously, as the name implies, for stability purposes. But when you're going down the road, it's going to help keep the trailer from doing this. It also helps keep the trailer from doing this. When you reach your campsite, because those wheels are set further apart, the trailer's less inclined to even rock around on your campsite. It's a double benefit here. And more outside storage. Everywhere you look on this, they open it up. Again, over 50 years of experience building RVs, Coachmen's got it figured out. Now, this has a really cool option on it. We won't always put on these, but it's very friendly for park-type units, park-friendly units like this. It's called the RVI, E-Y-E. There's a camera on the back and a camera under the awning. Think of this very much like a backup camera over here. The thing is, it has its own in-house Wi-Fi system that operates those cameras. There's a free app you download on here, and I've actually done a video on it, so you can search RVI, E-Y-E, on our YouTube channel to see how that works. I run you through setting it up. It's quick, it's easy, it's simple. Now, what's neat is, at your destination, you can use this to back into your campsite. You can also use this one over here so that you can see if anyone's messing around on your campsite to make sure everything's where it belongs. Keep an eye on the grandkids, so to speak. Now, here's another thing that blew me away on this. They created a full-size outside kitchen model that has no bunks, and that is an exceptionally rare thing. So once again, this breaks the mold again. It's classic but space-age modern, all wrapped up into one. We've got the bigger fridge. We've got seamless countertops out here. You will find these countertops through the entire RV. They're seamless, they're waterproof, so they're not going to sponge and swell and whatnot. And they leave you extra little appliances over here to charge phones and run little appliances and things. And the Coleman camp grill that recesses over here, it does not connect into the RV's existing propane system. There's nothing wrong with grills that do that, but they are a low output, so if it's somewhat windy, they're not going to work. This will work even on a windy day. Plus, it's perfectly portable. You can take it anywhere you want, so if you're going to have like a cookout at the buddy's house, take it with you. And then all you got to do, pull it down, latch it down, seal it shut. And they even give you extra little twist locks here to keep this thing extra sealed so that you have just no risk of water penetration. Now, this is not necessarily a direct to bathroom entry door, as is really popular. You can see it goes right to your rear master suite, but the bathroom is right there. So if you want to hop in and out real quick, you can hop in and out where there's no carpet, so you're not going to track dirt through the trailer, and you know, just make a quick bathroom stop. Easily accessible going down the road, by the way. Power awning, push the button, get some shade. Not an uncommon concept. The nice lighting under it is a nice touch. We do have outside TV hookups here right under the awning, so right where you're going to set a picnic table. Little details make big differences. Anybody can tell you that. Ounce of prevention's worth a pound of cure. That's why they have seal gripping slide walls. See the sandpapery looking stuff? It's going to pull these seals as taut as they can be so they don't get crimped halfway in and out. They're crimped. Water can walk right into that seal and walk right into your trailer. Also, notice all your windows are UV tinted. So one, you have privacy. Two, it's gonna keep your RV cooler. Three, they all open for ventilation. Every window, obviously the one exception of the ones in the door, open for ventilation. Let's talk Asdell. Woo, Asdell! This stuff right here, Asdell, you can see it in the door jamb, these white panels right here. That's what's actually under the fiberglass. It's lighter than normal Luon plywood that goes under this. It's rot proof, mold proof, mildew proof. I mean, it's just a resin. It's mostly melted pop bottles. That's seriously the primary component's melted pop bottles, so it's very green. The other thing is it has a higher insulative quality than common Luon. So this inch and a half ultralight wall has the same insulative quality. It has the same R9 as a 2-inch non-ultralight wall. Instead of 7, it's a 9. Also, fully enclosed, forced air heated underbelly. So great extended season RVing. Plus, enclosed underbelly does help with towing because you now have less wind drag and resistance. There's less things for the wind to grab onto. Now, right when you walk in, we've got our control panel up here, away from the grandkids' hands. It's up high, and boop, one switch LED lighting. Neat little thing about this is, like, you can see if you have your patio light on at a glance, or your water heater, water pump, you can glance at it and tell your status of your systems. One switch LED lighting, and they have an awesome lighting package in here. Let me kind of, if you're epileptic, you might want to look away, but there you go. This interior decor is called Willow. Probably due to the little willow-looking things that we have here. It's very natural, very earth-tony. I like that quite a bit. And it fits in with the total interior-exterior scheme very well. Again, though, if you like everything in this except, like, the fabrics, chances are we got another one in stock with different colors. You know, we generally don't single-stock anything at our dealership. So, again, what is old has become new again. A classic front entertainment with tons of storage. But they've bumped it up a notch. We've got newer electronics. We've got an electric space heating fireplace. This is a full trifold memory foam sleeper sofa over here, so you can sleep the grandkids or guests over here without cutting off the trailer. So many floor plans. You'll have like a height of bed here, and when you open it up, it will almost meet this kitchen right here. So you cut the floor plan in half, and you can't use your own trailer because someone else is sleeping on your sofa. Not the problem here. Big full super slide over here. This is quite literally a rear entertainment fifth wheel flipped around. It's literally a flat deck fifth wheel, guys. And that's what makes it so awesome for long-term camping. But a very unique quality on this is its interior height. And maybe it doesn't translate well to video, but this is exceptionally tall in its class. The average ultralight is 78 inches tall. This is 6'9". It's significantly taller inside, and that allows for taller cabinets, a taller shower, taller slide outs. This is not a bunk model, otherwise it'd give you more bunk room too. So that makes everything bigger and more spacious. It's what allows them bigger windows and overhead storage instead of or. And is better than or, basically. Again, remember, now here in the kitchen, we'll get back to the kitchen, but I want to mention, since I'm talking about it, we've upgraded solid surface countertops as part of the Premier and Liberty packages. Otherwise, again, our standard countertop is still better than industry standard with that sealed resin edge on it. So we've got a theater recliner over here, dual recliner, with extra bonus storage. If there's one thing Freedom Express does well, it is a lot of storage. Now, what's cool is that front pass-through storage runs under here, but there's still good interior storage space because that bullet nose on the front of this thing is so heavily swept that it still leaves interior space even once you have that pass-through. Now, you are going to have to just somehow make do with this 55-inch high-def swing-out TV here. So you can make the TV face your super slide. You can make it face your hide-a-bed at night. You can make it face the kitchen while you're cooking if you're watching your favorite chef, like Emerald. Bam! Kicking it up a notch, you know? I'm being facetious, obviously. This is freaking awesome, guys. This is absolutely awesome. You've got like a true home theater entertainment system here. This can be a space heater, so you don't have to use your propane, but you can also just turn it on for visual aesthetics if you just want the look of a fireplace without the heat. AM, FM, CD, DVD, Bluetooth, all-in-one entertainment. And lots of room for extra little things you want to bring with you over on the side here. I told you that's a hide-a-bed. Again, more storage overhead. All the windows have pleated shades, so you can have full privacy in here. But remember how you couldn't see in the windows. You've already got good privacy in here. Flipping around, give you a nice little look of the super slide the other direction. Let's look at this sofa real quick, or pardon me, dinette. They gave you easy access to the dinette benches for storage, and this one, the storage comes to you, which is super cool. I like things like that. And you can see how your drawers are all plywood constructed, not particle board with a sticker wrap. Everything's made to last longer. This table is freestanding and elliptical. So if you want to fold it down, you can bring it over here or in front of the sofa like a coffee table. You could use it as extra kitchen prep space. You can take it outside like an extra picnic table because the camper already includes one. This pantry's sweet. When I first saw this floor plan, it was just kind of closed like this, and I was like, not very impressed. I just wasn't really impressed. And then I opened this thing up, and I realized this goes all the way behind the refrigerator. And then I realized, again, they took it up another notch by making this stuff adjustable and putting a hanger up in there. So you have awesome, awesome kitchen space. Now, I'm a sucker for kitchen bar stools. If you've seen any of my videos, I've said that before, and you already know that's true. It takes me back to, I think, just eating sandwiches at my grandma's house, basically. She'd set me at the kitchen counter, make me a sandwich, and I'd sit there happy as a pig in slop and just munch away. It was great. So this harkens me back right to my youth, but it's awesome. And I love how they recessed these. They don't stick out in front of the door, you know? Again, taller interior means more overhead cabinet space, and this level change right here for like a serving station is so, so smart. They've gone to an under-mounted sink, and this is a stone cast sink. It's lightweight, but it's not going to melt if you are boiling water and pour water in here. A little sprayer faucet, by the way. Little extra lights are always a nice touch. Ooh, I just keyed into that backsplash. That's sharp. Double kitchen window. That's another thing I just keyed into. That is cool. Get some really good airflow in here. And those are under the awning. You could leave those open when it's raining. Very cool. So one of my favorite things Freedom Express does is what I call the U-tensile drawer, which frankly is neither very witty or funny, but I call it that, so that's what I'm going to roll with. But it gives you the perfect space for all of your utensils, and if you are having an outdoor picnic, take them with you. Set them up here. It's service time, folks. And then when you're done, roll back in here. Take it out. Clean it. Do whatever you got to do. Great storage, too. And more drawers. Drawer space. You know, nothing wrong. No one ever complains about more space. This is an update at the time of this filming. One of the more recent things in here is this food grade cutting board here. This little butcher block looking cutting board. I love this thing. It's so residential looking and feeling. It's just got such a cool personal touch to it. It's lightweight, it's real strong. Now what I like about it is, again, it's the perfect little serving platter. You can move it anywhere, everywhere you want, and it's purposely fitted so that it just right slips right on top of here, and there's little rubber grommets to keep it from slipping around. Now over here, again, storage everywhere, plenty of storage, and people go crazy over this Coachman clock. Don't know what it is, but people steal these out of the campers like crazy. It's ridiculous. It's just a clock. I don't know. I don't even know if it's a fancy clock, but it seems to be something people love because it's got Coachman and Spot the Dog up here. I haven't figured it out, but you know, it doesn't have to make sense. It just has to work, I suppose. Once again, one switch, lighting, and I love these big paddle handles. The reason for me is because when I wake up, I'm a zombie. I'm going to walk in here and I'm going to slap the wall until I finally hit the switch, and that helps me. Waterproof countertops. Don't forget that, because you're right next to a water source. And again, taller interior means taller shower. So this thing is tall nerd approved. The skylight up here is nice for the extra light in here. Even without the one switch lighting, you're going to be plenty bright. And it's remember how I described this thing as a flat deck fifth wheel? I wasn't joking. This is like a fifth wheel shower. And I like the little seat in the corner. It's just enough that it's not obtrusive, but it gives you a place to sit down if you need to sit to bathe or shave legs or anything. Porcelain, nicer than plastic, foot flush stool, and plenty of leg room even for tall goofballs like me. Moving on. Sliding pocket door for a rear private master suite. This is a true queen, 60 inch by 80 inch long true queen, not a camper queen, storage below. But check out the details. Power outlet, bedside stand, power outlet, bedside stand. You know what most trailers, even fifth wheels, with slide outs don't have in the bedroom is bedside stands. You can charge a phone, you can plug in your CPAP breathing machines. They never forget that in here. And that is one of the things I like about Coachman. They never forget the people that go camping. And if you're a reader, you're really going to like this. You've got dual element lights. Tap it once and it glows blue. And it's not real bright, but when it hits a white piece of paper, it'll glow the paper so that you can read without disturbing your partner. Now, hold it. Ta-da! Like magic. We got a nice bright light so we can actually see what we're doing in here. Again, like a fifth wheel bedroom master suite, we've got this huge closet, and it actually does. There's actually even bonus storage over here, just extra little shelf space, so that they never waste a single ounce of space in here. So the whole thing has tons of storage, but what is that over here? We've got, instead of a central vacuum, which frankly is kind of clunky, they give you one of these really impressively powerful Dyson handhelds. It's got its own little charge station there, so you don't have to find a place to store it. It has its own storage space. It's very cool that way. And you really want to, you know, just kind of make this thing feel huge in here. When this is all closed up, you've got all those mirrored doors going. When you walk in this bedroom, it feels massive because everything looks twice as big. TV stand up here. This is not storage, and someone's going to say, why not? Because there's an outside kitchen here, don't forget. But they made it look very organic without taking anything away. And you've got more than enough storage space going on over here already. This thing's a hit. This is going to be a big deal, and I can guarantee you, you're going to watch other manufacturers start coming out with things like this, because remember what I told you outside? Freedom Express is one of the most copycatted ultralights on the market. I'm not exaggerating. It is easily one of the most copycatted RVs on the market. Non-lightweight brands steal concepts from Freedom Express because they're just so darn good. They're just so darn good. So give us a call. Learn more. 800-256-5196. We do hitching, pieces, parts, financing, trades. We can deliver this to your front door, and I don't care where you live. I'm in Southern Michigan. I don't care if you live in Timbuktu. You give us a chance to put a quote on this thing, you literally have nothing to lose by calling for a quote. You might find out we've got some pretty sharp pencils, and that's why we sell well over 1,300 RVs a year, and that ain't just local, folks. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.